Hey, it's Kurt at the Top Corner Hockey Studios, Top Corner Hockey on Facebook, Top Corner Kurt on Instagram. Thanks for watching. It seems like forever ago since the NHL was scoring 6 goals a game. In fact, it's only happened once in the last 20 years, and that was 05-06, right after the season-long NHL lockout. Can you believe it? Back in the 80s, they were averaging 7.7 goals a game. Into the early and mid-90s, that number was 6.4 goals a game. In the last 5 years, the NHL has virtually been unchanged, scoring at about 5.3 goals a game. Back in the 80s and early 90s, when goals were going in a little bit easier than they are now, there were a lot of players that were making a name for themselves as NHL goal scorers. Guys like Gretzky, Mario, Yzerman, LaFontaine, Savard, Howardchuk, these were the guys pacing these high goal scoring eras. But there were a lot of guys that were just behind those players that were pacing the race. With a plethora of so many goals and goal scorers during the 80s, early to mid 90s, there were a lot of players that we've forgotten about, that aren't in the Hall of Fame, but were terrific hockey players and scored a lot of goals during that period. Here's my top 10 goal scorers from the 80s and 90s that you've forgotten about. Number 10, Paul MacLean. Yeah, the same Paul MacLean that won Coach of the Year with the Ottawa Senators in 2013. Back in the high-flying 80s, Paul MacLean, still rocking the mustache, by the way, was a stud with the Winnipeg Jets. From 1981 to 1990, MacLean had 9 straight 20-goal seasons, including 8 30-plus goal seasons and 3 40-plus goal seasons. In 84-85, Paul MacLean scored a career-high 41 goals and 101 points. Number 9, Tim Kerr. Tim Kerr was a bigger version of Mike Bossy, standing 6 feet, weighing 225 pounds. Kerr was a big man with soft hands. Sadly, like Bossy, back injuries very much limited their careers. While Bossy earned a trip to the Hockey Hall of Fame, perhaps with a little more time, Kerr would have 2. From 1980 to 1990, Kerr only played in 534 games, but stacked together 8 20-plus goal seasons, 5 40-plus goal seasons, and 4 times 50 or more goals. Kerr's 0.62 goals per game average during this period are better than Gretzky's career average. Number 8, Brian Propp. Kerr's Flyers teammate, no wonder Philadelphia finished first in the Patrick Division 5 times during the 80s. Brian Propp recorded 9 straight seasons of 20 or more goals. Mixed in there are 7 30-plus goal years and 4 40-plus goal seasons. Brian Propp was talented enough to make the 1987 Canadian team for the Canada Cup, arguably the best hockey team ever assembled. Number 7, John MacLean. The heart, soul, and face of the New Jersey Devils for years. It was John MacLean that took the Devils from Mickey Mouse organization to playoff team and then Stanley Cup champions in 1995. For a while there, MacLean was pretty much the only goal-scoring threat on the Devils. Drafted 6th overall in 1983, MacLean went on to score 8 straight 20-goal years and 10 overall during his career. From 85 to 97, MacLean scored 330 goals and is a 3-time 40-plus goal scorer. Number 6, Bernie Nichols. Well before the great one became his teammate in LA, Nichols was an established NHL goal scorer. For 10 straight years, from 82 to 92, Nichols scored at least 20 goals in a season. 7 times Nichols went over 30 in a season. And then there was, of course, that magical first year with Wayne when Nichols buried an astounding 70 goals in 88-89. Although he slowed down a bit after he was traded for Mark Messier, Nichols still had a few 20-goal seasons left in him with New York, Edmonton, and Chicago. Number 5, John Ogrodnik. Boy, before coming up with this list idea, it had been a long time since that name had appeared in my head. Never the main man on campus, Ogrodnik was still a reliable goal scorer from 1980 to 1991, when he secured 20 goals in 10 of those 11 seasons. 7 times Ogrodnik went over 30 goals, and in 1984-85, Ogrodnik found the back of the net 55 times. Ogrodnik is one of those few players to have scored more than 40 in a season with two different teams. He did it with both Detroit and New York. Number 4, Stéphane Richer. A French boy becoming a junior hockey superstar and then graduating to the Montreal Canadiens is a dream that Stéphane Richer got to live. As a 19-year-old, Richer was already too good for junior, so the Habs called him up and Richer went on to score 12 straight 20 or more goal seasons. From 1985 to 1997, Richer also tacked on 5 30-goal years and twice was a 50-goal man. Richer won cups in both Montreal and New Jersey. Number 3, Pat Verbeek. Between 1985 and 1996, the little ball of hate scored 375 times. In that period were 9 straight 20-goal seasons, 7 30-goal campaigns, and 4 40-plus goal seasons. Perhaps even more remarkable is Verbeek scored 40 goals for 3 different teams. The Devils, the Whalers, and the Rangers. He won a Stanley Cup with the Dallas Stars in 1999. Patty Verbeek also holds the distinction of being the most penalized 500-goal scorer in National Hockey League history. Number 2, Brian Bellows. One of the most hidden gems on this list, all Brian Bellows did was score goals. From 82 to 94, Bellows racked up 12 straight 20-plus goal years. A part of there were 5 straight 30-plus goal seasons. One of the youngest captains in NHL history scored 415 goals during his 12-year tear here between Minnesota, Montreal, and Tampa. His 55 goals in 89-90 were a career high. Brian Bellows also won the Cup with the Habs in 93. Steve Larmer. Many believe Stevie Larmer should be in the Hockey Hall of Fame, and his numbers provide some evidence. For 11 years in Chicago, Larmer never missed a game. He scored 20 or more in 12 straight years. Larmer had a run of 5 straight 30-goal years, then another string of 4 straight years with 30 or more goals. 5 times, Larmer cashed in 40 goals. Larmer played for Team Canada and won the 1991 Canada Cup, plus a Stanley Cup with the Rangers in 1994. While coming up with this list, a lot of players from the 80s and early to mid-90s came into my head. These guys I used to have hockey cards of, and I remember getting their hockey cards, looking them up in the Beckett magazine, and thinking that they would have a high value because of all the goals they were scoring, and then finding out they were worth 25 cents and that kind of stuff. I never forgot that. With so many players from the 80s and 90s scoring so many goals during that era of higher goal scoring than we have now, I'm sure there are a lot more players that you can come up with. I came up with a lot more, so perhaps we'll have to do another list like this again. In the meantime, tell me in the comments below some of your favorite goal scorers from the NHL from the 80s, early to mid 90s. Also, please continue to like and subscribe. I'm Kurt, this is Top Corner Hockey. Thanks for watching, see you next time.